How's it going, everyone? My name is Ruby, and today I'm bringing you guys a Photoshop tutorial. In this tutorial, I will be showing you how to create a clean, simplistic header for Twitter, and if we hit 50 likes on this video, I will be releasing the free template to this design, so make sure you guys give this video a thumbs up, and let's begin. The first thing you want to do is go up to File and Need to create a new Photoshop document. Since we are making a Twitter header, the dimensions will be 3000 pixels for your width and 1000 pixels for your height. We want to change the resolution to 100 and change the background contents to a white background color and click OK and click Create. Now, what I usually do when starting a new design is that I add some rulers just to keep my design symmetrical. To add rulers, go up to View and make sure rulers down here is checked. So you get these rulers right here. And now you can just drag these guidelines to your liking. I just usually drag them to the center of my document. You can just add them wherever you want. It doesn't have to be like mine, but you can just do what you like with these rulers. The next thing you want to do is create a new layer by going up to Layers, New, and Layer. And that's how you can create a new layer. Or you can simply click this folded icon down here and that will create a new layer. Now that you've made your new layer, you want to rename that just by double clicking it, and you want to rename it to Circle. And you just want to rename your layers to keep it nice and organized. So now with your circle layer selected, you want to go to your tools bar and select the ellipse tool. It's going to be this tool right here, ellipse tool. And we want to set the fill color to a black color. So click this and make sure it's black. And if you have any stroke, we want to remove that by clicking this icon right here, and that will get rid of your stroke. Now with the circle layer selected right here, you want to start drawing your circle by holding Shift and Alt and dragging your mouse outward, and you should get a circle like this. And holding Shift and Alt at the same time keeps your shapes in proportion, so you don't have a out of shape circle. So you should have a circle like this, and just drag that where you in the middle where you placed your rulers. Now we want to create three layers above the circle layer, so just click this icon three times and you will get three layers. We want to rename the first layer to pink. The second layer we want to name that to purple, and the last layer you could just name that blue. So once you've done that, you want to select your brush tool. It's going to be this tool right here. Make sure you are using a soft brush. It's going to be this brush. Make sure the opacity of that brush is set to 100 and the flow is set to 100 as well. So now we want to change the brush color of this to a pink color. So I'm just going to click this icon right here, and this allows me to change the color of my brush. I will be using a pink color, so the color code for that pink would be FF009C, and that gives you a nice pink color. So once you have your color code set, you want to click OK. And you want to go back into your layers panel, and we want to select this pink layer. Now with that pink layer selected, you want to lightly brush the circle, the outer layer of your circle. So you just want to lightly brush it like this. So just lightly brush the outside of this circle. And once you have that, you want to right click on the pink layer and create a clipping mask. And you should have something like this. Next, you want to change the brush color to a purple color. So select this icon right here. And you want to change the color code of this brush to A600FF, and this gives you a nice purple color. And again, we want to go back into the purple layer and we want to lightly brush the outside of this circle like we did using the pink brush color. You want to just do something like this, and we want to right click and create a clipping mask. Now for the layer that we called blue, we want to change the brush color to a blue color. I will be using the color code 0064FF, and that gives you a blue color. Now using our blue brush, we want to lightly brush the circle with some blue. You don't want to be too harsh on it, just lightly brush some blue onto there. And again, we want to right click and create a clipping mask. I will change the opacity of this by going up here and changing this to about 24 or 40%. And that should be set for your blue layer. So you should have something that looks like this. Okay, now we want to create another new layer, and we want to name this middle. And we want to drag this layer in the bottom right here, in the bottom of pink. And with that middle layer, we want to change the background or the brush color to a purple. So I will be using the same purple that I used before, this purple right here, and click OK. And we want to change the size of this brush so that it almost fits the entire circle. And we want to click in the middle and lightly color it like this. We want to change the opacity of this layer to 24%. And you should have something that looks like this. Now that you have your entire circle colored, you want to click on this circle layer, hold shift and click on this blue layer. And you want to right click and convert to a smart object. And you could just name this circle and just rasterize it. So you should have a layer like this, a circle that looks like that. So you want to duplicate that layer, so click Ctrl J on your keyboard and that will give you a copy of the circle. And you want to bring that copy in the bottom of the original like this, so just drag it down here. Now we want to resize it by clicking Ctrl T on your keyboard, and you want to resize it by holding Shift and Alt and dragging outward, and you should have something like this. And you just want to expand it and rotate it. So you should have a shape like that. And again, we want to duplicate that layer. Click Ctrl J, bring that copy in the bottom of the circle. And we want to, again, click Ctrl T and we want to resize it. And you just want to rotate it again. So you want to do this about four more times. Just click Ctrl J on this layer, bring it down here. You just bring it down here and you want to click Ctrl T and you want to expand this and rotate it, and you want to do the same two more times. So click Ctrl T and just expand it. Make sure you always hold Shift and Alt so it keeps the proportion of your circle. And do this a few more times until you get the shape that you want. So click Ctrl T. And you want to expand it again. And you want to do this one more time and you want to drag this down here. Click Ctrl T and just expand it all the way. Like that. And you should have something that looks like this for your final result. And now we can add some text, logos, or social media. So I'm just going to open up my 2000 subscriber GFX pack and I'll be right back. So I'm here in my GFX pack and I'm just going to drag and drop a logo that I like into the banner that we're making or the header that we're making. So I'm just going to be using this Myth Gaming logo as an example. You can use any logo you want or any text that you want, but I'm just going to be using this as an example. So once you have your logo, you just want to put that layer above all the circle layers and you want to resize it by clicking Ctrl T and just resizing it to your liking. And you can put that logo in the center of your circle. So you should have something that looks like this. And again, we can add some social media. So let's just say I want to add a YouTube icon. So I'm just gonna drag and drop a YouTube icon on here. I'm just going to add that social media right here. And I could do the same using another social media. So let's just say I want Snapchat. You can use any social media icon like I said before. So just drag that right here. And you should have something that looks like this. So now I'm going to add some text. The font that I will be using is Nexa Bold. And I will leave this font in the description so you guys can use it. And just change the size of it to around 24 and make sure the background or the text color is set to white. We want to zoom in to the YouTube and grab our text tool, holding T, it's this tool right here. Now you can just write whatever you want. So you can write your YouTube name. We could double click this and just resize it to your liking. And click this check mark up here and you can just drag this text like this. So you can just add whichever font that you want and you can resize it. And we want to duplicate that text layer by clicking Ctrl J on your keyboard and you get a duplicate. And with that copy, you want to just drag that to the Snapchat logo right here. And right here, you can just write Snapchat. So you should have something that looks like this. And you can play around with the social media icons. So once you have your social media icon set and your logo set, you want to click on all the layers by holding shift and you want to right click and merge the layers, convert into a smart object and just rasterize that. Now I'm going to add some noise just to give the header some texture. So to do that, you go up to filter and go to stylize, noise. And you want to add some noise. I usually do about 4 or 4.5 for the amount of noise, and it gives you this texture right here. So if you add more, it gives you some more noise. But like I said, I usually go around 4 or 4.5. And it gives you that nice looking texture for your header. So that's pretty much how you guys make a clean, simplistic Twitter header. So make sure you guys leave a like for the free template to this design. If we hit 50 likes, I will be releasing it. So I hope you guys enjoyed. This was my first tutorial and sorry if I stuttered, but make sure you guys subscribe for more free GFX templates and make sure you guys like the video for the free template. Hope you guys enjoyed.